Hi, in this video, we are going to discuss about remainder theorem. Remainder theorem states that the remainder of the division of a polynomial f of x by a linear polynomial x minus r is equal to f of r. Now, in this illustration, when you divide a polynomial by a linear polynomial, it's going to be equal to f of r. When a polynomial is divided by a linear polynomial in the form of x minus r, it's going to be equal to f of r. Ngayon, ang question natin is, saan manggagaling yung r na nandito? So, the value will be coming from the divisor, which is x minus r. And kung titingnan nyo rito, x minus r will be equated to 0. And kung itatranspose nyo yung negative r, you will be able to get the value of x. And yung value ng r na yon will be substituted to all the x's in the given polynomial. So using this remainder theorem, we will be able to get the remainder. So let's have our example. F of x is equal to x cubed plus 7x squared plus 7x minus 6 divided by x plus 2. So, pag dinivide daw natin itong dalawang to, it's going to be equal to f of negative 2. So, saan ang galing yung negative 2 natin? Dito siya galing sa divisor na x plus 2. So, in-equate lang natin siya sa 0, tapos itranspose yung positive 2, kaya nakuha yung negative 2. The remainder theorem will help us determine the remainder when a polynomial is divided to a linear polynomial. How do we use the remainder theorem? Step 1, from the divisor x minus r, find the value of x. Step 2, substitute the value of x in the polynomial. And step 3, evaluate and find the remainder. Okay, let's have our example number 1. Using the remainder theorem, find the remainder of x cubed plus 7x squared plus 7x minus 6 divided by x plus 2. Now, first step is we're going to find the value of x. So, using the divisor x plus 2, equate that to 0 and then transpose positive 2. So, yung value ng x natin will be equal to negative 2. So, ito yung gagamitin natin sa step number 2. So, in the polynomial function, f of x is equal to x cubed plus 7x squared plus 7x minus 6, substitute nyo yung value ng x. Or lahat ng x dyan, palitan nyo ng negative 2. Okay, so next step is to evaluate. That's step 3. So, f of negative 2 is equal to negative 2 cubed plus 7 times negative 2 squared plus 7 times negative 2 minus 6. Now, in negative 2 raised to 3, that's going to be negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. So, that's going to be equal to negative 8. And then, negative 2 squared will be equal to positive 4. Then, 7 times negative 2 is 14. And then, copy nyo lang yung minus 6. Okay, next step is to solve na natin yung 7 times 4. So, that will give us 28. Sunod, negative 8 plus 28 will give us 20. And then, negative 14 minus 6 will give us negative 20. 20 minus 20 will be equal to 0. So, if we are going to find out the remainder, using the remainder theorem, dito sa ating given problem earlier, ang remainder is 0. There's no remainder. So, okay, let's have our second example. So, let's look for the remainder of the polynomial x cubed plus 7x squared plus 15x plus 14 divided by x plus 3. So, kunin yung divisor, x plus 3, and then you equal that to 0. Transpose yung value ng positive 3. So, ang value ni x will be equal to negative 3. So, in the polynomial function, Substitute nyo yung value ng x. So, lahat ng x dyan, palitan ng negative 3. Okay? So, magiging f of negative 3 is equal to negative 3 cubed plus 7 times negative 3 squared plus 15 times negative 3 plus 14. So, lahat muna ng exponents yung isolve natin. So, negative 3 cubed will be equal to negative 27, tapos yung negative 3 squared will be equal to 9. Okay, sunod na step is yung multiply. So, 7 times 9 will be equal to 63. Then, sunod, solve natin itong dalawa. So, negative 27 plus 63 will give us 36. And then, minus 45 plus 14. So, 36 minus 45 is negative 9 plus 14. Magkaiba ng sign. So, you subtract and then copy the sign of the bigger number. So, f of 3 is equal to 5. So, our remainder is 5. Example number 3. Using the remainder theorem, let's look for the remainder of this polynomial, 2x cubed minus 5x minus 7, and its divisor x minus 2. So, using the divisor x minus 2, equal natin yan sa 0, transpose, value of x will be equal to positive 2. So, sa polynomial function, replace all x with positive 2. And then, solve natin lahat ng may exponents muna. So, 2 cubed will be equal to 8. Then, 5 times 2 is 10 minus 7. So, dito, paano nakuha yung 16 minus 7? 2 times 8, that's 16, and then negative 10 minus 7, same sign sila, add the number, copy the sign, kaya nakuha yung negative 17. So, 16 minus 17 is equal to negative 1. So, dito, ang remainder natin is negative 1. Okay, let's have our last example. Using the remainder theorem, find the remainder of the polynomial x raised to 4 plus 5x cubed minus 11x squared minus 25x plus 29 divided by x plus 6. Now, first step natin is to look for the value of x using the divisor. So, x plus 6, equate that to 0, and then transpose positive 6, your x will be equal to negative 6. So, in the polynomial function, replace all x with negative 6. Then, solve muna natin lahat ng may exponents. Yun yung negative 6 raised to 4, negative 6 cubed, and then negative 6 squared. Take note of the signs. Okay? So, negative 6 raised to the power 4 is positive 1,296. Negative 6 cubed, ito yun, is equal to negative 216, negative 6 squared is equal to 36, and then kinopy lang yung negative 25 minus 6. Okay, sunod na step natin is to multiply. So, 5 times 216, that will be equal to negative 1,080. Then, negative 11 times positive 36 is negative 396. Negative 25 times negative 6 is positive 150. So, solve na lang natin or evaluate natin yung mga susunod na numbers. So, take note, pag magkapareho ng sign, add the number, copy the sign. Pag magkaiba, unlike sign, subtract the numbers and then copy the sign of the bigger number. So, inuna natin is 1,296 minus 1,080. Sagot dun is 216. Dito siya galing. And then, kinopya lang natin yung negative 396. Tapos, sinolve na natin to yung same sign sila kasi. So, 179 yung sagot. So, 216 minus 396 is equal to negative 180 plus 179. Ang remainder natin will be equal to negative 1. So, you can use the remainder theorem. Medyo mahaba-haba lang siya kapag ang polynomial nyo ay may mataas na degree. But again, you can use this remainder theorem to find out your remainder. I hope you learned something today. Kung nahihirapan, pwedeng ulitin panoorin ng video. And don't forget, practice pag may time. And if you find this video helpful, huwag ipagdamot ang likes at mag-subscribe. Share mo na rin to other students like you. Thank you!